Hello, everybody. My name is Dr. Shola Moshigbamimu. I'm the founder and editor of the Women in Leadership publication. And I want to say a big thank you to the Amber Foundation for inviting me to join you virtually to discuss this pivotal issue of stereotyping women, typecasting them, tagging them with labels. Now, this is not a new phenomenon. This has been going on for hundreds of years. Across different cultures and different societies, and it's time for it to end. The difficulty and challenges that women face when they're typecasted is that, quite frankly, it holds them back. It stops us from expressing ourselves because we are worried that people will perceive us in a certain way. It creates this perception and imposes a certain view on women that does not in any way promote women's rights. It needs to end. These labels are not made by us women. They don't fit us, and we are not a one-size label for anybody to put a label on us for. So what can we do about this? I think first of all, we need to start by accepting the fact that these labels exist and say to ourselves, we are not going to accept them anymore. Shrug off any label that anyone tries to attach to you. It is unacceptable. Exercise the freedom of choice you have to be who and what you want to be. Do not be afraid to make the choices that suit you. Follow your own passion. Don't follow the tide simply because society expects you to be that. Simply because society wants you to be a mother, don't go be a mother because of that. Because society expects you to be a doctor, don't go and become a doctor because of that. You have to follow your passion. You have to be who you want to be. Make decisions. Be bold for the change you want to see. Thank you. I hope you all have a great time.
Each of us tends to typecast or tag the other person based on sexuality, color of skin, religion, the kind of person they are, body shaming, and all of this is at best divisive. We don't look at people in terms of what they contribute or who they are. It is time we stop doing this. It is extremely humiliating for the other person, and certainly for women it becomes even worse. We tend to be able to tag them based on whether they stay out, what they wear, what they look like, what they do, their kind of power equation, and this has to stop. It has to be unacceptable. How do we do that? Through education, through awareness, through being able to impart both for men and women a kind of awareness that goes beyond this particular form of tagging or typecasting.
Hi everyone, my name is Ida Teresa Myklebost. I am an Norwegian American film director based in New York. My work is mainly about politics, documentaries, human rights, and I've actually done a couple of projects in India. So one of the issues that I often experience being a female director is that people aren't used to that concept, right? Some people are having a really hard time getting instructions from a woman. And instead of then thinking, oh wow, here's a person or a woman who's acting like a director, they will think, oh wow, here is a woman who isn't acting like a woman should act. So if it was a man who was doing it, he would be congratulated on it, but because it's a woman, she's taking up too much space. She is too confident. She is too loud. She thinks she knows too much. She's bitchy. Another way that people might react negatively is by trying to take the control away from you. So for example, and this is something that I have experienced myself, is when I engage somebody to work on one of my projects and they solely in the capacity of their gender find themselves qualified to take over my director role. No, Ida, I got this. And I'm just like, you got this. This is my job.
Hi, my name's Anjali Bakshi, and I want to talk about tagging and typecasting in education. I'm from the UK, and here there's an issue of the lack of female representation higher up in the higher rungs of, you know, levels of employment and certain professions, etc. And with regard to education, you know, girls outperform boys from the age of about 3 up until around 16, but there seems to be a decline in their achievements, and I think this is something to do with the curriculum. I think this is something to do with the culture, but eventually, you know, you see that there's a lack of representation, you know, in terms of number of females represented on boards of companies, you know, executives, CEOs, etc. And I think this is because, you know, girls are generally pushed to take certain type of subjects. There's a clear lack of representation of women in STEM.
Hello to the Ombra Foundation. Thank you for inviting me to speak today. My name is Carrie Gibson. I'm the president of EcoCentury Technologies and Planet 5050 champion for UN Women. And thank you for inviting me to speak on this specific topic today. I always have something to say when it comes to diminishing women in any capacity, whether that be through bullying or harassment or name calling or more violent endeavors. But I think typecasting and tagging is rather insidious. It is one of those things that we brush off because it's not as severe as other bullying or assaults might be, but it is emotional abuse when it comes down to the nitty-gritty of it, and we women do it to each other just as much as men do it to us. And so we need to step up and acknowledge that using these words like slut and slag and harridan and nag and bossy and barren and whatever else that comes out of our mouths in a diminishing or derogatory way against another woman, well, we need to start thinking about she for she. Because how on earth are we going to get the men to step up in a he for she movement if we're not buying what we're selling?
Hello everybody, my name is Ana Maldonado, I'm from Ecuador. I would like to thank Vinita for inviting me to be part of this wonderful initiative She Speaks. About the topic, the labeling and typecasting women, all of us, we know that this is not a new issue. But I think that now we have the opportunity to have more tools in order to fight this problem. One of them is the internet. I think that now we have the YouTube, we have all the social media, you know, Twitter, Facebook, in order to share what happened with us. So these tools are giving us a voice through the world. Other thing that I really think we have to work is empowerment girls. You know, since we are children, we are teach how to behave, what to do, what not to do, because we are women or we are girls, that guys. So I think that now we have to change this kind of things, that this kind of thoughts, and we are going to have a more empowerment woman with their own voices. Thank you so much again.
We are talking about tagging and typecasting. While tagging and typecasting can be a big problem for a man, it might clip his wings, it might narrow his ambition, it's a huge, huge problem for a woman in our society. It not only clips their wings and takes away from them their freedom, it puts them into chains, in bondage and in a jail, and it takes away from their dignity. We all do it subconsciously. This initiative, She Speaks, is an important step that is being taken to make us aware of that and to make sure we do not do that, because sometimes we don't even intend the harm that we bring upon women by typecasting them, by labeling them. It is very easy for us in our society to call women by 4 or 5 broad terms: Devi, Ma, Behen Jaisi. But the rest of the things that we call women, are very derogatory. And those terms put women in a bracket that they will find themselves very difficult to break out from. Is it not possible to celebrate the beauty of a woman, to celebrate the intelligence and the sexiness of a woman, the attractiveness of a woman as well, by not bracketing them? I wish all the best to this new initiative.